This is Genki Cover Dog. It's 10 times smaller than the official dog. And this is Genki Cover Dog Mini. Now it's 20 times smaller than the official one. It must be the most pocketable dog in the market. I bought many third-party dogs after Switch came out, and this cover dog is my favorite. Now this mini version is here. I've been using it for 2 weeks. It's as reliable as the big one. All safeguards remain in place to ensure that consoles and other systems are free from overcharging. When there's no TV connected to the HDMI port, it acts as a normal fast charger. When connected, it becomes a dock for Switch, iPad, and Steam Deck. It supports 4K output, which means I can enjoy high-resolution movies from my iPad. Like Cover Dock, Mini Dock has foldable prongs, which make it very easy to be packed away in any pocket or bag. I love Mini Dock's incredible size, but everything has its price. There are two costs for smaller size. The first one you may have noticed is that Mini Dock doesn't have USB port. This could cause inconvenience. For example, when I go out playing Smash Ultimate with friends, I need USB to connect GC controller hub. Now with this mini dock, everything has to be wireless. Fortunately, I have this Bluetooth adapter from Abido. The second one is power output. Mini dock has 20 watts while the big one has 30. I think maybe it's because mini dock doesn't use gallium nitride to keep it from overheat. But 20 watts is still enough and it's cheaper. Now I have 3 docks and I use them for different purposes. The official dock sits on my gaming desk. I need its full functionality. Genki Cover Dock is hidden in this plug box to connect Switch and iPad with TV. As for Genki Cover Dock Mini, I just toss it in my bag along with USB-C cable and stand. Then I'd be TV mode ready wherever I go. Okay, this is all I want to share today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm Weatherman, see you next time.